Hi guys, this is Fabiana from creativeswimwear.com. Today we are making together this beautiful bikini bottom. I wanted to make a design with using this ring, because it's really fashion now. A lot of swimwear brands are using the ring. So I'm gonna teach you in this tutorial how to crochet around the ring and include the ring in your crochet bikini. Also, I'm gonna tell you how to line it after, because this bikini definitely see-through in its lining. And so subscribe to my channel and like my video if you've been watching my videos. I only make swimwear. I have around 30 something years in experience only making crochet swimwear. That's what I like doing. So yeah, if you like, just leave a comment as well. And that's our project for the day. So we will need for this bikini lining, I'm using polyamide lining, but if you have any other color, if you're using any other color around here in this edging, you can probably use lycra as well. Lycra is fine. Like if you want to make red here and use the red lycra behind it, I think would be really cool as well. So you can, you know, just mix and match colors. So we can use the lycra as well. This ring, it is made of bra, and it is 3 centimeters or an inch and a quarter big. You probably need the same size, otherwise you change the whole pattern. And okay, so we're gonna need for this piece around 50 grams. So 50 grams is one ball. So you're not gonna use the whole thing, but definitely 50 grams of the cream and just a little bit of this color or whichever other color you wanna use. This is 100% cotton 4-ply yarn, and you're gonna need needle, a thin needle, and thread. Thread same color of your base color of your bikini. Scissors, of course, and your hooks. The hook is I use this metal one, tulip from Japan, number one. 1.6 millimeters, so your hook's 1.6 mil. And that's all you need, guys. Let's start this project right now. So, to start this bottom, we're gonna start with 6 chains. So, slip knot, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then slip stitch in the first chain there. We are going to make the same triangle we did on top. Slip stitch here. Then 1, 2, 3 chains. And then 2 double crochets together in this first one. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 chains, and then another 3 double crochets together. Two chains here, and then 3 other double crochets together. Two and 14s. Three double crochets together. Oops. So one, two, three. So you had 14s here, now it's two. 1, 2, 3, 4, we're gonna make 6 times 3 double crochets. 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 chains, 3 double crochets together. That's gonna make like a flower in the middle. 2 more chains and then single crochet in this first 3 double crochets together here. And then from here, I'm gonna make 5 chains, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 2 double crochets together with 3 chains in between them, another one here. So that's gonna be our corner. Okay, and then 2 more chains and 3 normal double crochets in these 2 chains from before. 2, 3, 2 more double crochets, 2 more chains, and then our corner again. So this corner is 2 double crochets together, 3 chains, and 2 double crochets together, all in that same arch from before, 2 more chains, and then where you had 2 chains, we're gonna make 3 double crochets, normal double crochets. More chains, and then another corner here, one, two, three, one, two double crochets together, and to finish here, 2 chains, always after the corners and before is 2 chains. And then here on the last one, we're gonna make 1, 2 double crochets and a single crochet in the 3rd chain here. Okay, now our 3rd row. So see the corners are gonna make the triangle. So 1, 2 chains. And then my 2 double crochets in these 2 chains from before. Two chains. And then the corner, which is always the same. So 1, 2 double crochets together. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2 double crochets together, and my 2 chains. And then here, I'm gonna have 2 double crochets in these chains from before. 1 double crochet in each one of these double crochets from before. Two more double crochets in the 2 chains from before, and then my 2 chains and the next corner. So we will be repeating this We'll be making 4 rows, okay? And just repeat this, the 2 chains, the double crochets in here, double crochets in here, and double crochets in these 2 chains. And then, so just make 1 more row after this row here. So, I finished here, and I had 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 in the middle. That's my 4th row. So 1, 2, 3, 4 rows. Okay, if you are making a medium, make 1 more of these rows here. So make 5. If you're making a large, make 6. This is a small size. And all the rest is gonna be the same, okay? So we finished here with a slip stitch here in this last. In these last 2 chains, and now I'm going to start right here in this corner here, right there on the corner. I'm going to make double crochets here, and this is gonna go, this is gonna make my back part. This is the very small, very cheeky bikini, okay? So, 2 chains there, then another chain here on your another double crochet here on your 2 double crochets from before. Normally, 2 double crochets, they count as 1 stitch, okay? And then 2 here in these 2 chains. And then 1 each double crochet across, and the same at the end on the other side. Always hold the tail with my finger on the back, so I just make these double crochets right on top of it, and that covers my tail. Okay, so then 2 here, 1 in here, and 1 more. Next chain. Okay, so I'm going to have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 20 stitches here, 20 double crochets. And now I'm going to just make 2 chains and start decreasing here. So skip 1 double crochet here and make double crochets across now. All the way to the end. And here in this last 2 double crochets, we are gonna make only 1, okay? Next row, make your 2 chains and turn. Next row, we want decrease and sew the crease every second row until you have 12 stitches. 12, always counting with the two chains from the beginning, okay? And when you have 12, make 17 rows. So decrease every second row until you have 12 double crochets, and then keep repeating your 12 double crochets until you have 17 rows, counting, not counting from the triangle part, just 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17, okay? So I finished here my 17 rows from counting from the end here. So we count from here 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17, and then I cut it off because I had a long tail on the other side, so I can stitch both together later. And now I'm going to start making the sides. So start here, right in the middle, like this. Always make my first single crochet with both sides of the yarn, the tail and the working part, and so three more chains from there, so three chains total, and then two double crochets in here in the two chains, one chain, skip one here, two more, one chain, skip one. We'll be working just with this stitch now, two double crochets and one chain, skip one. We should have five. Five times two double crochets. So from here we're gonna go to the second row and make three chains and turn, and I'll always be making the two double crochets on top of that chain from before. So two double crochets and one chain, two double crochets, one chain. And at the end we're gonna skip. So here in this last part here, instead of making your chain, you're just gonna make a double crochet here. So you're gonna decrease and you're gonna decrease again on the next row, so you're making 1, 2, 3, and then you're gonna skip that two and make your two next double crochets in that next chain. So you're gonna decrease until you have six rows or six rounds. Here to this side, you don't decrease here, okay? You're only gonna decrease here in the middle. So here you make your normal two double crochets and the last one in that chain there. three again to turn and make your two double crochets here. One chain, two double crochets, one chain, two double. Oops. One. Slippery. Two. And now here you decrease again. So one double crochet in the third chain there to decrease. And then one, two, three. Two double crochets in chain, one chain, two double crochets in chain, and don't make the chain there, just double crochet in this third chain there. So now I stopped increasing, okay, stop decreasing actually, stop decreasing. And then you're gonna repeat this same row. And then I have one, two. And here you'll be making now two double crochets on the beginning. So you're gonna be repeating this same row. Until you have so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. So you're gonna see, you're gonna repeat the same row over and over again on this side. Okay, and then we're gonna conjoin both sides together with just single crochets. So here you have three times two double crochets, and here you are going to make three chains, turn. So you're not decreasing anymore, okay? So yeah, on this side I don't have the ring, I'm gonna have the ring on the other side. So this side I'm making 15, on the other side I'm going to make a bit less rows, because I want the ring to be right on the in front of the bikini, like right in the middle. So repeat this row until you have 15 rows on this side. And then the other side, you can repeat this same thing, the same increasing, so you're gonna make the same thing again. But you're only gonna have 9 rows. Okay, so you make 9 and stop. So after finishing your 15 rows, so counting from the triangle, not with it, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15 rows. I'm gonna after leave a long tail so you can join both sides together at the end. Okay, and now I'm going to turn around and start from that same place, the other side. And so on the, in this other side, I'll be only making 9, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, because I want the ring here, I want to put the ring right here, okay? You can have the ring on both sides if you want, and then you only repeat this side now, so it's 9 rows. The same way we did before. Okay, so I'm gonna make my 9 rows here. I'm gonna actually first I'm gonna make So here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stitches, okay? So I'll be making 8 stitches in my ring. So the way you do it, pull the hook through the ring, grab the yarn, bring it to the front, and then make your first, I like to have more tail at the end, because I like to always, so leave a little bit more tail at the end there, because I like to cover it with the stitches, and then make your first single crochet there. So from here, put on the back again, pull it, and make another single crochet. So I'll be making 8 of them each side, because I have 8 at the end there. So 2, 3, 4, pull the tail a bit, 5, 6, 7, 8. After finishing this 8 single crochets, make 1 chain, turn, and in the second single crochet, just make single crochets here across. I think that's gonna make it easier for us to join both sides together later on, having another row of single crochets here, because otherwise it would be too close to the ring and too hard. Okay, 2, 4, 6, 7, and 1 more here at the end to make 8. So 8 single crochets, and you can finish here. Just in case, leave a little tail, just in case we need like a few centimeters of yarn like this, so we can stitch both sides together later, and then repeat the same on this side as well. Made the same thing here on both sides, because I already covered the tail with a few stitches. I can now pull it to the back here and just cut it off. Just cut it off here and here. Okay, and I left 2 long tails on each side where I'm gonna be joining with this side I'm making just now. So make this other side with that 9 rows, repeating the same thing from before. And then I'm gonna show you how to join them together with the ring. So yeah, just repeat what we did here before, exactly same thing, but 9 rows instead. So when you count 9, you can stop, because then we're gonna join with the ring. Finish there my 9 rows here to this side. That's the shorter side where I'm gonna put the ring. Okay, I made 8 stitches to each side of the ring, and then with my I left long tails here, and then with this tapestry needle, it's a thick needle, I'm going to stitch together with this first side here. And so you have to be facing the back side of the crochet, not the front, the back, because the stitching needs to be on the back, and this you should be facing the front, so when you turn it, it will be both fronts to the front and not to the back. So you're facing the back and you're looking at the front of the ring, and then you just wave it. So go there in your first stitch on the other side, and then on the second stitch here and here. It's raining a lot here today. It's springtime and the summer's coming. Always rains a lot. So yeah, be just waving one each, one time in each stitch. Okay, and then just make a knot at the end. And make sure they both finish in the same stitch. Okay, and wave it. I'll probably just hide here somewhere and hide it in a few stitches so it doesn't open. Oh yeah, oh, it looks good. That's how it looks on the front. And then now you can stop, pause this bikini, pause this video, and you can make the back side of your bikini, which I've already done. So as you can see, this side I made it longer because it has to go around my hips and to the front. Okay, so I use this on this one 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20. So I made 20 rows on this side. So with both facing, yeah, make sure you make longer to the right side, okay? So, and here I have just 15 to each side. 15 rows here and 15 rows here. On this side, 20 here and only 9 here. And so pause the video, and then when you come back, you just stitch, join here together with your ring and join this part here. And the part here, I'm gonna be joining them the same way I did on the ring here, just with the needle. Okay, so do that, and then when I come back, I'll be teaching you how to make a last row around the entire piece using elastic. Okay, so if you are making a medium, make one more row each side. And if you're making a large, make 4 more rows than what we just did here. So here you still always want your 9 rows, because you want this ring to sit on the front. So always make 9 here, and then you can add up on the back to go all the way around your hips. Okay, now I'm going to make my rows around with the elastic. So elastic, I always cut it, I cut it a bit shorter. See the total side there you have on your leg? So less 2 inches. You see there at the end, less 2 inches around this, much smaller. Okay, and then the other side you cut the same. But the only thing is that because of this ring, we're not gonna join both ends here. This one I'm gonna join both ends because this side is closed. But because here I have the ring, I'm gonna start from here, and then I'm going to fold it here and just make a few stitches at the end. And the same with the waist there. Make sure you cut it a bit smaller than the full size, around 2 inches each side, okay? And don't join the ends. So I'm going to start here, right on this side where I don't have the ring. And I'm going to start right here. You can start anywhere really, but I think it's easier to start right in between the legs. Okay, so just pull the hook from any of your stitches from before, pull it back, make one stitch with both sides together, and then we're gonna use this elastic that we already stitched both ends together there, and place it right there just before the beginning here. Place it under your work like that, right under. And then single crochet on top of it. Normally I make 2 single crochets to each of my rows. So one in between both rows and one in the middle. And just make sure you cover all that elastic so it doesn't show on the front. I'm covering the tail together as well. So just cover it with single crochets. This tail here, okay, and just make single crochets all around the leg space here. When you get to here, to this part here, to the side, you're gonna be pulling the elastic, so it will be the same as here, okay? So do that, go all the way around. When you get to the sides here, see I'm on the side, make sure you pull it. So, because the sides are the part that will hold on, that will make sure the bikini holds on your body. So they need to be elastic. And that's the reason why we cut this elastic shorter before. It's because this on the sides you're gonna always be pulling it Okay, and make enough single crochets so you cover all the elastic. As you can see, you can't really see it. So you can make as many as you want. There's no count for that. As soon as it covers the elastic, that's the main thing. And as well, the more single crochets you make, the more elastic your bottom will be. Because if you don't make enough, it won't be elastic like that, you understand? So you need to make at least 2 single crochets in each row for the bikini to be able to, you know, elasticize, to stretch. So pull a bit more and keep going all the way to the end here. Cover these ends here, these both ends of the elastic, with a few more stitches as well, and then finish here with slip stitch. Almost forgot to say that all these single crochets we are making on the right side of your bikini. So, okay, so because the wrong side, sometimes it doesn't cover enough and you want to be on the right side of your bikini to finish it in any way, you know what I mean? So to start this, but this side of the this leg where I have the ring, I'm going to put my hook from this first single crochet here, right next to the ring, and pull it back here, and make this first stitch here, and then straight away place the elastic like that on the back. Later on, you're gonna be making like this side, you're just gonna make a few stitches here. And that's really well finished. It doesn't bother when using it, so it won't bother when using it. So, okay, made that first stitch there as I always do. Now, leave the tail here to the side and place your elastic just like this behind the crochet. And then you're gonna be covering the same way you did before. So hold with this finger, pull the first single crochet, and pull that tail as much as you can. And now just single crochet. I'm making my single crochets on top of that tail as well. A few more. And then that's enough, I think. I just pull it to the back, it's not on the way anymore. And so here, if you want to make, put a pin here, safety pin here, because you remember you're going to be pulling the elastic, I don't need to because I know how much I can pull. Or when you're pulling it, you just hold the end, so you know the end doesn't come through the crochet when you're pulling it. So you keep making your single crochets on top of that elastic seam. It covers the whole elastic. Maybe here I could have had one more. One more single crochet here, because we want to cover it so people can't really see. So my elastic is a 3 millimeter swimwear elastic. You can use, I think 3 millimeters for this bikini is perfect. 5 millimeters would be a bit too thick. 6 millimeters is definitely too thick for bikinis. So 3 millimeters is perfect. It holds and it's thin enough so you can crochet on top of it. So just keep going all the way to the other side, and on the other side you're gonna have a little bit like that as well. Here I had much more, so what I'm gonna do is just cut it. Just cut it and fold it, and then stitch with the mirror needle and thread. That's the ones I'm using. And then we are going to make the last row of picot stitch, my loved picot stitch. That's because I use the same one on my top, and that's gonna be with this color thread. So I covered all my elastic with the single crochet, and then here I already did here. I stitched them like right near the edge. So you just fold it. And with this needle and thread, you stitch it. Pull it a bit more if you need more, you know, a bit more of the elastic to stitch it. And that's how I do it. Make a few knots so it doesn't open. And then here on the other side as well. And then you can cut here as well. And this is how it looks like now. On this bottom, I'll be making this finishing here, same one I had on the top. And so I made two sides already, because it's very simple. So you always start it facing the right side of the bikini, because you obviously want the right side of the crochet to be on the front, like on the right side. So start here in this first knot after the ring. Pull your hook through, yarn over, bring the yarn back, and make your first stitch here. And then single crochet in this next single crochet. And keep the tail here, right here. I'm holding with my finger. So you just crochet on top of this tail, so you don't need to finish later, you only cut it off, and you're good to go. That makes the crochet work much faster, because you don't want to be using a needle to put that tail, to hide that tail behind later on. So yeah, I'll be making 4 single crochets, one in each single crochet from before, and then the picot stitch, which is 2 chains, hook through this single crochet just before, and single crochet here. and then another single crochet in the next single crochet. Put that tail behind now, you don't need to cover it anymore. And then 1, 2, 3, 4 single crochets, one in each single crochet from before. And then 2 chains here. Hook inside that same single crochet from before and single crochet here. And then single crochet in the next stitch. So 1, 2, 3, 4 2 chains. Single crochet in this single crochet here and single crochet in the next single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4 You're going to repeat that all the way around until you get here, and here you just finish with a slip stitch and hide the tail on the back like I did here. And that's it, guys. Then our bikini will be ready. See how stretchy it is? I really like that's how it is stretching. That's gonna make it fit perfect on your body, and it won't come off when you're swimming. That's the main reason why we use always a smaller elastic on the legs and waist. So the lining, the way I did it, was I found out that because there's this little see-through here, and you only need lining here anyway, I cut this way. So the way I cut it is, you can either put a cut a piece of paper of this with the same size of your bikini, and then from that piece of paper you cut the fabric, or like I do, I just put the fabric right on top of my crochet bikini and I cut it from there. Cause it really it's like you can't pre-cut it, because every crochet bikini has a different size, and so it's always gonna be different, really. See, even here I'll have to cut off a little piece because it's too much fabric, so I'll have to come and cut this off even after stitching it. So yeah, and then the way stitch is like this, just wave it up and down. Same color thread of your crochet yarn. If you don't have the same, just white would be good enough for this one, I think. Would be fine. I don't go with, when I'm stitching, I don't go all the way through it and back. So I just, what I do is just like this. Like just through there, you know, I don't go all the way to the other side, so the thread won't really show on the front. And the reason why I didn't fold this lining for this bikini, it's because if I fold it, it will show here on this open spot. So yeah, just like that, it doesn't show the stitching at all there. That's what you're aiming for. So this is it. That's how it looks like at the end. And this is the other side. Okay, so this was our project for the week. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It was a bit more difficult design because of this ring here, but I really wanted to make one with the ring, because there's a lot of people using rings now in their collections, swimwear collections, and I think the ring gives a very nice look to a crochet bikini. Hope you enjoyed making it. Please subscribe to my channel, leave your comments, and like my videos. That helps me a lot to keep making videos for you guys. And hope you had fun like I did. Loved making this bikini. So see you guys next week with another one.